Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So guys, as you know that we have started a year-long test series for the UPSC aspirants with history optional. So this is a kind of year-long timetable in which what we will do, we will give you daily targets and we will be taking your test on every Sundays, and there will be a revision test on the last day of the month. So today is the first day of your this year-long test series. Actually it is 9 month test series, but as 9 months are close to 12 months, so that's why we have written here year-long test series. So today's topics are sources of Indian history. So as you know that the first topic in the history optional syllabus is sources by which we study the Indian history. So that's why this topic has been picked up. So your today's target is to complete the this topic, that is the sources part of your Indian history. And broadly your sources are divided into three parts, that is archaeological, literary and foreign accounts. So archaeological sources are basically those sources that have been unearthed, or for that matter that are associated with material remnants. So this archaeological sources cover your exploration, the excavation carried by the archaeologists, and also the epigraphy. Epigraphy relates to the inscription reading and all those inscription or edict reading for that matter of Ashoka or any other ruler. And numismatics, and numismatics include your coin reading and kind of constructing history through the usage of coins. And then comes your monuments, that is historical buildings that are built by the persons, or for that matter by the religious institutions who played an eminent role in the history, or for that matter who played a less eminent role, but their monuments are of importance. So these the archaeological sources will cover broadly these topics, and the literary sources will cover your primary and secondary. So you may know the distinction between primary and secondary. If you don't know, you have to read this, it is important. So you have to read primary and secondary sources, and also how we can use them, what are their limitations, and also you have to in literary sources come your poetry, scientific literature in regional languages, as well as religious literature. So these are the literary sources, and the foreign accounts are basically the travelogues, or for that matter the accounts of those people who have stayed at the court or courts of imperial rulers. So that is for example Greek accounts, Chinese accounts, or Arab writers accounts. So these are the basically sources of Indian history through which we construct a major part of our history. So you have to prepare these topics for today, so you don't have to worry about tomorrow. Just take an approach that focus on the day that you have before you. So today is before you, and you have to use these 10 to 12 hours in a manner that you also complete your general studies part as per your own timetable, and also you follow us on this timetable. And we promise that by February 28, 2020, we will cover your syllabus in a manner that you will be able to revise 3 times by February 2020. So you will have covered your entire history optional by February 2020, and 3 time revision will also take place, and this will place you in a strong footing when it comes to the optional subject. So after prelims you will not have to worry about the about completing the syllabus, because at that time you will then only focus on your test writing part. So let me explain to those students who are seeing this video for the first time that what this initiative is all about. So it is an initiative of for history optional students, and it is basically a year-long timetable to cover entire syllabus, as I have told you earlier. So how it will work, it is basically the detailed timetable of 9 months will be followed from 13 May 2019 to 13 February 2020. So there will be weekly targets that will be given to you. So as I have told you that today's target I have given you, in this manner we have prepared the week long target also. So you people will be shared those weekly targets and daily targets, and on every Sunday we will be taking your test of 6 questions. It is certain that number of questions will be 6. The numbers will not decrease, but certainly it is possible that the number of questions can increase in any particular test if we find any topic of that much importance that questions from different angles must be asked. tasks to you people. So your answers will also be evaluated by us people within 2 days of the test. For example, you have given the test on Sunday. You will get the evaluated answer sheets by Tuesday. So in this way, this will work. So on last day of the every month, you will be given a revision test, and you will have to give that test, and it will comprise of 20 questions. So we not only provide you the feedback, we also share with you the synopsis, or for that matter, you can call it model answers. But we don't like to refer it the answers as model answers, because no answer can be a model answer in UPSC. Only the value addition is the thing that is the purpose of model answers. So they will be shared with you for the purpose of helping you to do value addition in your already vast knowledge that you will be gaining through reading of books. So that will also be shared with you within 4 days of the test. And also the syllabus of history optional will be revised 3 times in these 9 months through these tests. So how it will benefit you, it is simple, that optional subject plays a decisive role in your selection, because optional subject has 2 papers, that is paper 1 and paper 2. So the total marks comprise 500. So if you take the percentage of 500 out of 1750, that is the total number of mains mark, then the percentage comes to approximate 28.5. So this is near to approximately 30%. So one third of your marks that are in mains are from optional subjects. So it plays a decisive role not only in your selection, but also in your the service that you get, that you will get, and also the cadre that you will get. So it is an important thing. So that's why we will revise this history optional syllabus 3 times even before your prelims, and test will be carefully crafted also to include the previous year questions as well, because given the importance of these previous year papers that the UPSC has taken. So which sources will be covered? Basically, IGNO BA and MA notes will be covered. Old NCRTs will be covered, that is India's Ancient Past by R.S. Sharma, History of Medieval India by Satish Chandra, and History of Modern India by Bipin Chandra. And also your History of Ancient and Early Medieval India by Upinder Singh, Early India by Romila Thapar, and Medieval India Part 1 and 2 by Satish Chandra, and your Modern India, that is from Plassey to Partition of India, and after by the Shekhar Bandopadhyay, and Mastering Modern World History by Manle, and any other necessary source which is important for you people, we will be covering that source. It means that you will be getting the questions from these books. So this year long timetable will ensure that you cover your syllabus and sources, different sources, in a time bound manner without wasting any time. So friends, as we are putting in a lot of effort, so certainly there will be a fee structure, and it is ₹9,000. So if you want to subscribe for the entire initiative, you have to pay a one-time amount of ₹9,000. But in case you find it too much costly, then you can go by component, or you can go on component basis, because history optional basically comprises of 4 components, that is Ancient India, Medieval India, Modern India, and World History. So per component we have kept the fee ₹2,500, and if you want to proceed on per component basis, then you are most then it is also acceptable for us, and you are most welcome. So certainly when the initiative will start, so as I have uploaded the first video today, so certainly the initiative has started. Now we have started the timetable from 13 May 2019. So don't think that you have too much time to prepare for optionals, because the early you start, the more beneficial it will be, and especially in case of optionals where you have to get a good hold on the subject. So in this way this initiative will work. So in case you want to subscribe, then you can email us, that is at this email ID, that is achieveies21@gmail.com, or you can also contact us at this number, that is 8968426481, or you can also join our public Telegram channel, that is http I don't know what to pronounce it, telegram.me/achieveies. So you can follow us on this link, and also you can subscribe to our YouTube channel. So thank you friends. If you like this video, then do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. Do not forget to press the bell icon, because then only you will get all the important updates about different things that we do on our channel. So thank you friends, have a very nice day.